Welcome to Chessington World of Adventures. It is HowlOween, and yes, we're starting the vlog inside of Vampire. You know why, Cody? Because we're bloody soaked. It is absolutely tipping it down with rain. However, we've got to Vampire first. The queue isn't too bad. I don't know where they're going. Let's do a bit of Vampire.
We're going to have to pause a bit on the outdoor activities at the moment because we have thunder and lightning here at Chessington. But hey, what's Vampire in the rain?
It's all a bit of fun, isn't it? Oh, how wet are you?
Very.
Very. So yesterday we were in Magna, didn't we?
Yeah.
What a great cycle Magna was on. So today we're going to do Crop Drop, which arguably looks better. I think we agree on that. It's not spinning though. It's not spinning again, Crop Drop. We just watched it go round. We did know at Portland's Park one actually only spins one way. It doesn't try and go left and right. I don't know whether that's something they should just look into. Last time Kurt and I come on it, it was quite violent. Quite a violent spin. It was a bit more like being on Ramesses than when it was being on Crop Drop, but the rain is easing off slightly. We are soaked beyond belief. But we're going to do Crop Drop. What's the worst that can happen, Cody? Can we get more wet? Yeah, that's it. Tim Blaster God. You're going to beat me. So last time we come on this, I came with Kurt. And he only lost by like 1,500 points. We were both in the late 70,000s. So how many points are you going to get, Cord?
22.
Wow, that's ambitious. That's proper ambitious, that is. That's just your final answer, is it?
No.
How many?
42.
Don't stop at 42 if you get there. No. I'll be watching you.
Okay.
All right.
I'm not even going to give up.
I think it'll be a bit busier than when Kurt and I come, to be fair with you, so I think the chances of us getting 70 plus is quite slim, but the rain is easing off, the park isn't busy yet, there's no shows for an hour or so. I'm gonna make the most of the rides while they're quiet.
Yeah?
That is good, isn't it? We like that. It's better than your 42 you thought. Good result, good result. Well, it's a long walk down the station now, Cod. It's like people get in the boat really, really quickly.
Which they don't.
What?
No.
Do they not? Let's hope they do.
Way back down. It's really pointless.
Yeah, I agree. I don't really understand why we've moved it so far forward. But fair play if it works. You ready? We're not going to get wet, are we?
No.
No.
We've also gone now from a control cabin to the world's biggest control office. Cody, how big is that space in there? Incredible, absolutely incredible. We're sort of winding down our time now for when the show started, about an hour's time. It's 11 o'clock, we've done Vampire. What else have we done? We've done Tomb Blaster, we've done Croc Drop, we've done Dragon Falls, Tiger Rock. I'm always gonna call it Dragon Falls, I don't know why. Station has changed a bit now. It was closed last time I come. They've sort of extended it again, and once again as well, the control area is huge. They've got like massive 50-inch TVs to watch on. I guess it's safety, but my God, it's huge, absolutely huge. There are a couple more rides we want to do. It doesn't feel very busy at the park at all, but it's not due to rain later until about 5 o'clock. So I think if people are visiting today, if they've got tickets, sort of between now and 5 o'clock, should be all right. So it might get a bit busier, but I think the rainy day guarantee will be activated today because there are thunderstorms due later on. Puddles everywhere. Right, wild age, here we come. Now we're going to be back very shortly for Trick or Treat Live. Sun's come out, Cody. I don't think we're going to dry, but the sun's come out. Brilliant.
Yeah.
You look at the airplanes.
Yeah,
right, that's a good ride on Fury there. Caught it perfectly. A real, real perfect spin. It has stopped raining now, so we are going to head round to Rattlesnake, which has reopened. And the park is getting busier, I'd say.
Yeah.
But we're only 20 minutes away from Halloween festivities and the mazes opening. We can't wait, can we? So we're going to do Vile Villagers early.
Yeah.
And we're going to do it again after 3 o'clock to see what the changes are, because obviously between 3 and close, it's more scary.
Yeah.
Do you think it will be?
No.
I don't think it will be either, but we'll find out. We'll find out, but first stop is going to be Rattlesnake. It's the open ceremony for HowlOween. The witches are in position. Everyone's been moved backwards. I'll tell you what's good, Claude. They're actually embracing the whole area rather than just the front bit, which they've been prone to do before. I think it's going to be the same for the World Asia show as well. So maybe they weren't quite as utilising of this space as what I hoped. I see no real reason either why they couldn't spread out round here, but that was quite good. That's quite fun and upbeat. Yeah. I've not heard the song before.
Neither.
No. Right. So now we have Trick or Treat Live.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're looking forward to Trick or Treat Live. That's usually good, isn't it? That's usually a good one. Right, opening ceremony done. We've just had a look to see if Dirty Fries is open, which it isn't. So we're going to head down to the main show and just try to establish what that is and where it's going. Any ideas? We're really lucky as well because Vampire has now shut up for the day. We got on it first thing this morning in horrendous weather and then it closed shortly afterwards.
Yeah.
And now it's listed as shut for the day. Yeah, the Fury queue's gone down a little bit, it still says 40 minutes. I just... I'm gonna get a good view of what this is. I mean, it's not the nun with the piano, to be fair, but it's entertaining. I'll hand them that, it's entertaining.
Halloween, my plans get put on hold because disgusting children up here, dressed head to toe in costume. Ugh.
Trick or treat live for 2022. Highlights in the video there. The show will be up separately, so you can watch it separately if you want to, if you're not coming down to the park or you want to relive it. Now, I think it definitely detracts a bit from not having a proper stage. I quite like the way they interact with the screen, but there's not a lot of props on the screen, so it kind of takes it away a little bit. But the costumes are amazing. Yeah, costumes and the costume changes, because obviously it's all the same people, is amazing. It really, really is. And by the way, Croc Croc's woken up now, it is spinning. Yeah, I was really, really, really impressed with the way they dance, as we always are with the shows. The music choices are great. Yeah, really good. Really good show. Really good show. Out of 10?
8.
8 out of 10, I agree. I agree. I just think it's the stage design that maybe have let it down just a little bit. But I don't think that can be helped. I don't think that can be helped. But again, amazing 10 out of 10 effort from the actresses. Actually, there's no actors. I think that's the first time we've seen a show without any men.
Yeah.
It's all ladies. But brilliant dancing, brilliant choreography. Absolutely loved it. Trick or Treat Live is on throughout the day. If you come to Chessington World of Adventures, do not miss it.
Whoa, toaster and marshmallows, God.
How you feeling about that? Quite like the sound of that. Right, that is two incredible rides on Dragon Fury, especially the first one. Caught it perfectly, absolutely perfectly.
And of course, Halloween, these used to be at Alton Towers. Everyone will tell you that because they've seen it. They're now here. They're just shops. Don't worry about it, just shops.
They're shops, Cody. Guess what? You don't get annual pass discounts, so we won't be shopping there.
Now then, we are going to go and try Vile Villagers. Yeah. So it's before 3 p.m., is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's before 3 p.m.
So it's two stages. It opens at 12. Between 12 and 3 is sort of, you know, lower class. Same for Creepy Caves. Creepy Caves only £5 between 12 and 3. And then from 3 till close, Creepy Caves goes up to £8, I think, yeah. Which is the one we're booked in on at 4:15. And Vile Villagers kind of notches up a notch to something else. There is sadly no Forbidden Forest walkthrough this year, which I am devastated about, because one, it soaked up the queues, and two, really did give something for the Litlands, which perhaps these two don't. I don't know what the thinking is behind that. I do think it's a real shame. I think it was a real quick win for the park. But Vile Villagers, you're looking forward to it?
Yeah.
And then we're going on Grufflo.
Yeah.
Right, that's the plan. Just while we walk past, Halloween food is also back. It happened. Sadly, no dirty fries today, but Ben and Jerry's has come to the rescue. Welcome down to Vile Villagers. I think we can film through here, so we're going to give it a bash. Now, there are two ratings. As we said, between 12 and 3 is a 2 pumpkin, 6 plus. However, from 3 till 7, it is 3 pumpkin, which is 10 plus. Now, bearing in mind they advertise Creepy Caves as a 10 plus, I'm really interested to see what the jump is between this and this. I would say the same on Creepy Caves as well, but I'm not going to lie to you. When I've got to pay £5 to go into Creepy Caves to find out what the difference is, I'm not doing it. We pay for the £8 one at 4:15 and we'll be doing that. Right, what do you think? Do you think it's going to be scary? It's not normally, is it? It's usually fun entertainment, to be fair, and it's not usually that scary. But I'm really interested as to why it would be 10 plus. All right, let's go find out. And this is usually really well put together. It's far more built up in here, isn't it, this year? Far, far more built up.
You really shouldn't be here. Master just loves new visitors, especially children. And that isn't a good thing. I promise, you don't want to be his favourite. You should go as quickly as you can, but please don't tell him that I'm
coming. Have you come to buy something? I have spells. I have a bucket of mystery meat.
I'm not sure about the mystery meat. What spells have we got?
I have one to turn your arms into snakes. Ooh. Or your legs into cucumbers.
No? Snake one sounds good.
That doesn't cost an arm and a leg, just one or the other.
What would you prefer?
The arms.
It's all about the arms.
You're not going to buy?
Maybe later.
Well then, you're wasting my time.
That's a lot of detail.
Everybody who comes through this area comes out alive. You aware of this?
Yes.
Well, I assume that you are new tourists here in the village.
We are.
Not returning. Well, be very careful. Continue onwards.
Sadly, no one in there.
I thought it was going to be someone in there.
Yeah, I think I'd expected someone in there.
That was quite good though.
We're back after three.
Yeah.
Yeah, back after three.
Middle.
Can you see me, Cod? You wanted to come on this, yeah? Gruffalo. Enjoy Gruffalo?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was alright, wasn't it?
So it is the same thing's not working, sadly. It just needs a little bit of love, Gruffalo.
Bless it, just needs a little bit of love. And we were offered to re-ride as well, because he's not sending them in quick enough. So these poor people out here, Cody, in a 20-minute queue.
I'll be
waiting even longer. But I like it, I like it. It just needs a little bit of love.
Yeah.
Little bit of love. Now, at Portland's Park, we saw the spiders, didn't we? Chessington got the pigs. Or goats. Goats. They look more pig-like.
They do.
But yeah, I get it now. I get it by the horns. They're quite cool though. Do you want to get one of those in the bag?
It's getting creepy in Wild Asia.
This is the story of Brandon. Many, many years ago, in a rainforest village, amongst the macaws and the monkeys, the tigers and the tapirs lived.
Thank you.
there's the Circle of Eight Banya show here in Wild Asia. Now, sadly, there's two reasons we're not going to be here when it's dark to see it. One, vampires closer today, and that's what we stay late for. But two, there are thunderstorms due in about an hour, like severe thunderstorms. I don't think Chessington or anyone's going to miss it. So come the next show, which is at 5:30, where it's going to be a little bit dusk, and the show after then, I have a feeling it might be cancelled. And we're not going to risk it, either, Tom. We're not going to risk it because we've already got soaked this morning and the weather warnings are in place this evening from 4 o'clock, no, about 4:30, just after our creepy caves, for severe thunderstorms right across the south. So we're going to be going, aren't we? We're sadly going to be going. We'll see if we can come back up and catch it. Kurt's here tomorrow, slightly better weather tomorrow. Maybe he can catch it for us. But it is a fantastic show. You enjoy it?
Yeah, it was good.
Yeah, really good. Really, really good. It's good to see eight. There were four last year, so there's eight this time round. And yeah, loved it. Loved it. Great effects. Right, now then, it's time for after 3 p.m. Yeah? After 3 p.m. Vile Villagers. Is it going to be different?
Can't be that different.
You don't think it's going to be that different? The thing is, this time we might get an actor in the end, but I'm pretty sure there's normally an actor in the end anyway.
I was going to say, you went and looked back.
When we sort of mentioned it on the way out, the guy standing at the exits went back and opened the curtain to see if anyone was there. So I think there should have been someone there anyway. But they are really interactive in there. It was a fantastic walkthrough, so I'm quite happy to go around and do it again. It's well gone past 3 o'clock now. Again, it's not dark, but I don't know how long that one's going to last this evening either, when the weather comes in. But we're going to go back. And then it's creepy caves time.
Yep.
It's all about the Halloween now. After 3 p.m.
Yeah.
After 3 p.m. After 3 p.m.
Right, hey, it's me!
It's not me.
And you know what? This is the last straw for you. Go in. Enjoy.
Cucumbers.
What about you?
The snake.
The snake. Where's your money?
Not for me.
Well, isn't that a complete waste of time? You can go. I would say good luck, but I won't, as you've wasted my time.
No.
No.
somehow I don't believe you. You look a bit on edge. A bit sweaty. Good. Good.
So close yet, so far.
Well done.
Good. I just can't keep a straight face when they stare at me.
There we go, comment below. Do you spot the difference between the before 3 o'clock and the after 3 o'clock? I
think they were more acting. Yeah, more acting.
They were more acting.
No.
Oh, you think beforehand? I think there's a little bit more of a queue before. Now, but I don't see it. I don't see it. I'm really sorry I don't see it. I was so hoping there would be someone in the tunnel on the last one. I know it's dark and there's strobe lights and there's smoke and everything.
Stick someone in there.
But I remember last year, because I remember we followed a group in last year and they had their arms crossed, so they let the actor know beforehand before going in the tunnel. So little bit disappointed. It could have been better, but it's still great fun. I mean, the actor interaction, as you saw on both run-throughs, are brilliant, and they are always brilliant in there. Very, very talkative, very, very in your face. And maybe they were a little bit more in your face that time round than the first time, but I don't see a massive difference. I don't see a huge difference. A huge difference. But you know, end of the day, we've done it now. Right, that is us out of Creepy Caves Elimination. That'll be the last time we ever get to do this maze. I've just seen lightning in the background, so we're gonna make this fairly quick. So the route has been reversed again. You go back in the top end, down the stairs, and then work your way through to the exit right here. Now, I have to say, the storyline is very much the same. It's all been about sort of the angel plant. The angel plant is now taking over the cave completely. So the idea is you're going through the cave, meeting the inhabitants effectively to blow up the plant. That's probably the reason as well, the storyline next year will be the plant took over, which is why Creepy Caves is going. There are lots of dark scenes in there, So you kind of get greeted, you go down, you get the story about the laboratory, and you get the story about the angel plant and how it's taken over, but before being set into the maze. And it's very, very similar in the fact you do go into decontamination first, but you're not split up like you were when you went in this end. And then you're... headed in, your tour guide is taken away, which is very similar, before heading into the maze. It's very, very dark for the first sort of, I don't know, it feels like a minute, but it's probably only about 30, 45 seconds. You're walking through, you don't see anyone, no one at all. I was starting to wonder whether anyone was actually in there. Someone then jumped out at us from the side, and all the rooms are very, very familiar. I still like the body bag hanging part with the strobe lights. I still really, really like that. I did have a couple of actors in it. But no one was really sort of in your face, to be honest. You've got to the end, and I could see the big red button on the side, but again, where I've done the maze before, I kind of know that I need to open the door to leave, so I think there is a danger you could just walk out, to be honest, because the actor that's in there is well hidden away.
I kind of waited for the announcement, hit the red button, the smoke comes out and all the sparklers and things, and yeah, it signals the end of the maze. I won't lie to you, I'm a little bit disappointed with it. I don't think it's as good as it's been in previous years. And we've got some people coming through now, so I'll pan them around in a second, because I can hear they just pressed the button, and just see what the reaction is as they get out. You can probably hear them. But yeah, it didn't really feel... I don't know. I've had better run-throughs. I think it was better the other way around. I think queuing down here was better. They don't let that feel, Cody. What did you think?
Good.
It was good.
Yeah.
You preferred last year's?
Yeah.
Yeah. I preferred last year's as well, to be honest with you. It's not a bad maze, don't get me wrong. I've definitely been through worse mazes, but, I won't pan around actually, but there is some tears. There is some tears. Before there would be tears, there's quite a lot of young people in the queue, and you know, it is dark in there and quite full on. But yeah, I won't lie, I'm a little bit disappointed, especially as it's the final year. I just thought it would be a little bit more full on. You know, we're in the afternoon slot, and I know they do an after dark, and I've heard stories about the after dark where you get grabbed, you know, and your hair pulled and pushed around and things, and that's great. But you know, I've been through some great scare mazes in my time that don't require waivers and things like that, so it shouldn't make a difference on it. Good maze, not great. Not great.
Cody?
Which one, this or Vile Villagers?
This.
I think this is better, but I do begrudge that I paid £8 for the afternoon one. I have a feeling the morning one would have been exactly the same. I don't think there's any more lighting in there. So, yeah, I don't know. And I miss the guys with the light up masks.
Oh yeah, they were cool.
They were really cool, weren't they? I miss them. But yeah, Creepy Caves Elimination, let us know in the comments below, did you do it? I don't necessarily want to know about the After Dark one. I know a lot of people I know have done it and said it's amazing, which is all very well. It's fully sold out. You know, there's 10 days left of Halloween and After Dark is sold out. So this is the only option we got, but I don't really want you pulled through a maze anyway. Because I can take you to sort of Scream Fest Extreme and you wouldn't get pulled through a maze and still be scared shitless. So yeah, there we go. Let us know in the comments below.